So this is the anomaly A. It's gigantic. It's roughly the size of at least four of these other eggs. These are unhatched eggs here next to it. This is nest number 1424 on St. Vincent National Wildlife Refuge. The craw was recorded on the 24th of June, 2014. And do you have the hatch out date on this one, Mike? Mike's checking the turtle log for the hatch out date.
The 19th of this month.
7 days
ago.
Okay, so we're going to measure this strange egg that came out. Was this near the top of the nest?
Yes.
And I've heard of this before with leatherbacks, but I've never, that they lay a larger infertile egg near the top. But I've never heard about it with loggerheads. So that's roughly, of course, that's really rough, but 12 inches this way, lengthwise and circumference, about in length overall on the top, about 5, okay? So 5 inches long when as it's lying on the sand, but 12 inches in circumference the long way. And then this way, it's roughly 3 inches. And in circumference, it is about 7 inches in the shortest circumference. So I just want to pick it up. If you can come in a little closer with this, I'll tell you when to stop because I know the focus of this. You can get a little closer than that. Okay, a little closer maybe. And I'll turn it over. It's leathery. It's almost like a skin on a baked potato skin, but it's soft inside and it just, it's got some kind of liquid in it. So we're going to call the biotechnician for the refuge and see if he wants, if he's ever seen this, if he wants to see it, and if he hasn't, what we should do with it right now. Well, he'll probably have us break it open. I don't know. We'll see.
There.
How big was it?
How big was it? Normal size? Right.
It was near the top of the nest.
Yeah, and it was at the top of the nest, too. I don't know if that makes any difference. Yeah.
One of the last.
Right.
One of the last ones she laid.
Yeah. Right.
Okay.
I
appreciate
you guys taking time. Thank
you
all for doing that. Very, very much. Appreciate it, man. No problem. Bye. He said, pop it open. He's seen them before.
That big?
Yeah, he said they're not, he says they're relatively rare. He also, he said the other day with Denise, yesterday with Denise, they found a couple that were relatively normal size, but they were like shaped, you know, with a cartoon character's speak bubble looks
like.
And they had like a little tail to them.
Were they near the top of the nest?
Yes.
Oh, well see, the one that would be one of the last ones they lay.
Right.
That's interesting. All right, she was running out of gas. Whatever. Yeah. One blast. We'll videotape, if you will, videotape us opening it, so we'll have that, so we can report it and so forth. I've heard about this. We'll have to look it up when we get home with leatherbacks. Tom told me.
You're good.
As long as you don't make a shadow, that's good. I wanted to try to get the nest number in here. Okay, so this is nest 1424. The last thing we're doing, Mike and Robin Vroegop, volunteers with U.S. Fish and Wildlife, is breaking open this very, very oversized egg that we found near the top of the nest. It doesn't feel like it's got any embryo in it, but we're just going to break it open and record close up what we see when we do so. And it's leathery, very leathery. So it looks much like the other unhatched ones that we had. I was going to try to see if I could count any individual yolks in it. Remember, the other ones were a little more clear. These look like scrambled eggs, really and truly. No odor. So, yep. It smells like egg. That would have made a whole omelet. I'm sorry, I didn't say that. But it was near the top of the nest, and like I said, I've heard about it from Tom, that leatherbacks, there's some theory that maybe that's some kind of a, they lay a large sterile one to kind of like throw off a predator. I don't know. We'll read up on it. So we're gonna cover this back up. Okay, we have one more to do today. I think that's 1411, right, Mike?
Correct.
All right, let's go do it.